Caleb Brooks with the AHSAA Radio Network. I'm at Spain Park High School. I'm joined by Michael Callens, our AHSAA Male Athlete of the Week. And Michael, you know, you get this honor because you had a great week a week ago. You run for almost 180 yards and had a touchdown in a tight game, a 14-7 game. And it was kind of surprising, I think, to a lot of people because y'all had played in a lot of shootouts all year. And I think a lot of people thought y'all in Shades Valley would definitely be a shootout. And next thing you know, you look and it's 14-7, but you had a lot of success in the game. What helped you run the ball so well and helped y'all able to move it on the ground? You know, really an aspect that y'all hadn't been as successful at all year, you know, throughout the year running the ball.
I just feel like my O-line, they came through a lot that game. My tight end, Jacob Jenkins, he helped a lot the whole season. And it's just like my last game, I got to put on the line, just go all out.
You know, Coach Rainey talked about y'all had a lot of young guys up front.
Yeah, we had one senior on the O-line starting. Yeah.
How tough was that?
It was real tough. They still got a lot of growing up to do, but
yeah.
I feel like they're going to get it together, though. They got a lot of years to work.
Obviously, there's a lot of communication that has to go on between you and the offensive line when it comes to pass protection, stuff like that. How difficult was that early in the year, you know, when you were dealing with a lot of
guys? Yeah, it was bad. But, yeah, they came along. They got it down, though. It was pretty good by the end of the season.
You know what? Tell me a little bit about those guys then. You know, obviously you feel like they got better and improved as the year goes on. So what do you expect from them now moving forward as they get older?
Oh, it's going to be good. That's gonna be good. They young, so they just like play a lot. They just real childish, but they gonna grow up. I feel like they gonna get it together though.
You know, y'all didn't have as much success on the ground probably as y'all would have liked this year, but you know, you were able to help in the passing game some and catching the ball out of the backfield. And you know, how much do you enjoy doing that and catching
that
some passes out of the backfield?
I tell Coach all the time, Coach, I'm a receiver, I can catch. So yeah, that was fun.
And you know, when you get involved in the pass game, how much does that open up other stuff and open up, you know, the running lanes and things like that?
Yeah, it opens up a lot. Like, coaches tell me, like, how I'm, like, unselfish, like, when I run in the ball and stuff. But them passing it to my receivers opens up, like, running for me. So I liked it.
You know, y'all put up points a lot this year. I mean, I don't think scoring points was the problem for you guys. What helped y'all click so much on offense, especially early? I mean, 42 on Hillcrest to start the year. A lot of people were kind of taken aback by y'all having so much success against a good Hillcrest team, you know, first game.
It was just a lot of chemistry that we had. We were just all budding together, coming together as a team and playing hard.
How much does playing 7-on-7s in the summer help now? You know, because like, we didn't really have that opportunity back when I was playing. It kind of was just starting to really come in with 7-on-7, but how much does having that opportunity to kind of get going and getting a rhythm summer help?
That helps a lot. That's why we had so many, like, passing yards, like, first game. Like, Harrison Barker, yeah, he had a lot of yards.
Does it kind of affect the running game any when you do spend all summer passing and then all of a sudden here comes August and we got to put the pads on and get physical?
Not really, because the O-line, they're always working, so...
Who was maybe a team that you would look at and say, man, that's probably the toughest team that we played all year?
Probably Thompson.
You think so?
Yeah.
What was it about them that made them, you know, as good? Because obviously they were undefeated before
they just got a lot of athletes.
Yeah.
A lot. Like, the whole team. Yeah.
And then, you know, I talked to Coach Rainey about Tuscaloosa County, and I talked to some of the Thompson players about it, and they felt like Tuscaloosa County had one of the better teams athletic-wise. What did y'all see from them when y'all played them?
The running back. They had a good running back.
Yeah. What was it like sitting over there and watching him on the other side knowing, man, this is how I got to live up to?
It was crazy. Like, dang, that dude pretty good.
And what was the adjustment like that week? Y'all had to move your game, you know, to Thursday, and it was the day before, so everything got thrown out of whack.
Yeah, to me, it was just like, it's another game day. I just got to go play hard. That was it.
Did it kind of throw y'all off any, you feel like? Because, you know, obviously you're going through the week expecting to play Friday, but then all of a sudden you show up to practice Wednesday and everybody goes, hey, guys, hey, we're going to go play tomorrow now instead.
Yeah, we found out, like, after practice Wednesday, like, we plan tomorrow. It was weird.
And, you know, do you feel like losing that Thursday did affect anything and losing that day of preparation that you're probably used to having? Did it affect anything in that game?
No, not really.
So, you know, when you look at some of the other teams that you guys played, who would you say, you know, when you look at it and – who's the best non-region team that you played? You know, you played Hillcrest, Bessemer City, Shades Valley. Who would you say is probably the best? You think so?
Bessemer City, yeah. They pretty.
How challenging was that game for you guys?
That was pretty challenging. They got a good young quarterback, too, so, yeah, that was a pretty good game.
What do you think about them and the 6A playoffs? What kind of chance do you give them?
I don't know. Pence Valley, they still doing their thing, so.
You think they're still the king until somebody knocks them off? So, kind of similar, you know, like, even though Phoenix City won it a year ago, tell me from a 7A perspective for all you guys. You know, Thompson won y'all's region a year ago, and they won it again this year. But for people around here, who would y'all kind of still look at and say, is Hoover still the team that people are still kind of?
See, like me, I'm saying like Thompson is the new Hoover now. To me, that's how I feel. Because I feel like they just.
So you feel like Thompson's kind of stepping into the role of being that standard at 7A up here in the North?
Thompson is like the Pinson of 7A, basically, right now.
And then, you know, when you look at your region, obviously, I think the toughest region in the whole state. Yeah. You know, I mean, y'all are not playing tonight and probably could have been playing, you know, if you're in any other region and y'all have other teams in this region in the same boat. But, you know, how do you feel about your region now matching up, you know, tonight against the region from the North? And what do you expect from some of these teams in this region during the playoffs?
It's going to be a lot of good games tonight. It's going to be a lot of good games because it's talent from both sides coming in.
You going to watch any of them? You're gonna hang out.
Yeah.
Is it too hard to go and watch?
Yeah, I was like, nah, I'm just going to chill.
I got you, man. But, you know, for you, I mean, you had success throughout the whole year. And you know, to end your senior season, to end your last high school game the way that you did, how special was that to go out and have the performance that you had?
I loved it. It was so much fun, like, the whole season. I love all my teammates. It made my senior year memorable.
And is it one of those things when you end it the way you did with 180 yards and getting a touchdown on Shades Valley, is it one of those where you can kind of now look back and you go, you know, well, I'm never going to regret anything from that because of how I ended it?
Yeah, because I finished it the way I wanted to.
Well, Michael, congratulations to you on being Athlete of the Week again, man. I hate that y'all aren't playing tonight, but only four can make it out of the region. And you know, so four have to sit at home, and y'all just happen to be one of them. But y'all had a good year, I'm looking forward to seeing this program grow. I know that you're going to be moving on and graduating, but I'm looking forward to seeing how this program grows, how these young guys grow, and I wish you nothing but luck in the future,
man.